From this lecture, we will start the study of metal semiconductor junction. We know that the formation of electronic devices requires putting two or more dissimilar materials, These materials can be metals, insulators, or semiconductors. The interface between these materials becomes crucial because it can affect the electronic transport properties. Of the electronic devices. We note that this interface is called the junction. An ideal junction is one where there are no defects formed at the interface. But we know that there are many defects in real materials, since most of the materials that is real materials have many defects. Therefore, forming of an ideal junction is very challenging. But we can get An idea. Of the interaction between materials by studying ideal junctions. We have already studied junctions between two dissimilar semiconductors. Now we consider an ideal junction between a metal and a semiconductor. So when a metal and semiconductor are brought into contact, there are two types of junctions formed depending on the work function of the semiconductor and its relation with the metal work function, or simply relation with the metal. So first type of junction is known as Schottky junction. And this junction is formed when work function of metal is greater than the work function of n-type semiconductor. This Schottky junction is also known as rectifying junction. And second junction is ओमिक जंक्शन। एंड दिस जंक्शन इज फॉर्मड व्हेन द वर्क फंक्शन ऑफ द मेटल इज लोअर देन द वर्क फंक्शन ऑफ द एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर। आई एम राइटिंग दिस सिंबल दैट वेयर फाइव एम इज द वर्क फंक्शन of the metal and phi sn is the work function of n type semiconductor. And let me explain some little about work function because it's very important. For the metal, we know that work function, that is Fm, is the minimum energy required to remove the or to remove an electron from the Fermi level of the metal. And we know that in the metal, there are plenty of electrons at the Fermi level. On the other hand, in the semiconductor, there is no electron at the Fermi level. Therefore, the minimum energy required to remove an electron from the conduction band of the semiconductor is known as इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी। नॉर्मली इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय जाई एंड दिस डेफिनेशन इज एप्लीकेबल अबोव एब्सोल्यूट जीरो। जीरो टेम्परेचर बिकॉज एट एब्सोल्यूट जीरो देर इज नो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द कंडक्शन बैंड ऑफ एनी सेमीकंडक्टर। सो सिंपली वी नो दैट फोर मेटल्स इफ वी ड्रा दिस इज वैक्यूम लेवल एंड इफ दिस इज फर्मी लेवल फॉर दिस इज द केस ऑफ ए मेटल देन दिस एनर्जी डिफरेंस हेयर ऑल स्टेट्स अप टू दिस फर्मी लेवल आर फिल्ड फॉर ए मेटल एंड ऑल स्टेट्स अबोव दिस लेट मी राइट इट एज ई एफ एम फर्मी लेवल फॉर द मेटल एंड ऑल द स्टेट्स अबोव दिस फर्मी लेवल आर एम्प्टी। सो दिस एनर्जी डिफरेंस इज द वर्क फंक्शन फॉर मेटल बट इफ यू कंसिडर इस सेमीकंडक्टर दिस इज द वैक्यूम लेवल दिस इज द मिनिमम ऑफ द कंडक्शन बैंड एंड दिस इज द वैलेंस बैंड मैक्सिमम ऑफ द वैलेंस बैंड लेट्स से दिस इज एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर देन वी नो दैट there is no electrons at this fermi level let me write it as e fs there is no electrons at this fermi level so it is meaningless to directly write it as work function but still in books or in literature we can find this as fermi level of the semiconductor. Normally in semiconductor this difference that is the minimum energy difference between minimum of the conduction band and the vacuum level is known as electron affinity. Here this is known as work function. So electron affinity is the minimum energy required to remove an electron from the conduction band of the semiconductor and this definition is only applicable when the temperature is above the absolute zero temperature because at absolute zero temperature there is no electrons in the conduction band of the semiconductor so it is meaningless to define this electron affinity but when we make junction we still use a term of work function which is nearly equal to the energy difference between this vacuum level and the fermi level so for simplicity we use work function of semiconductor as fs but here one thing is important for metals value of work function is almost constant it can vary with the plane and it can vary from various planes and it can vary by various defects but almost in general purpose we use a constant Wara function for metals. But in semiconductor, since we can tune this Fermi level, so the Wara function of any semiconductor is not a constant quantity. But this electron affinity, the difference between the conduction band and the vacuum level, is constant. So most of the time we use this electron affinity to define the properties of a junction with a metal. So these things are very important to consider before starting of this new section, that is metal semiconductor junction. So in next lecture we will study the Schottky junction in details.